children gets a box toilet. Something you're required to do every Sunday after church instead of practicing football. I know. They were trained from the age of 7, from £90 all eight, and they never miss. It's also a National Trust policy that if you can catch an ammo, you can also have a free ice cream at the camper. Here they come again.
Whee.
Now you can see the full impact of the war, though, on the 14th century battlefield. However, against a shot from just like this second day of battle, the morning of Monday, the 24th of June. It's 4 a.m, first light, and feast day of St. John the Baptist. To our left, the Scots have come down off the high ground, balcony bridge, down here onto the wet ground, the carts. And in kneeling prayer, the ordered not taking prisoners this day. The clap track and grace. Now, the English army see this and they think they're sent to mercy. That is not the case at all. The Scots are spoiling for a fight. Right here to our right, the English vanguard is going to fight. Led by the 23-year-old Earl of Gloucester, the second richest man in England. He's been called a fool and a coward the previous day by his cousin Edward II. He has everything together. He charges the 800-meter long Scots line. Let's see how he acts. Now he's also across the north of all the food. All that honour and that weaponry about Oaks and Unwork is not enough to save it. Order, Zona is sacked. This is also how the Scots come up with the idea of the back. Boston is sacked back into the Shelton, and it's finished off very quickly. Both sides of Bannockburn did have cavalry, but what is the difference? For the seamen here training the Pente. Over here to our right, we've got the English horse, left by the Earl of Pembroke. He's beating through the wall at the Battle of Medan during 10 seconds. He needs Edward II's house on. When he rides a destrier, heavy war horse, ready to fight down, hit and bite anything in his path. About 2,500 Bannockburn. To our left, we've got the Scots cavalry, led by Sir Robert Peace. And he rides a much faster pony, a hobby. Only about 300 at the battle, they are still deadly nonetheless. When they hit each other, they will be travelling at just under 55 miles an hour. You don't want to get in the way of that. The English army have about 6,000 archers, but as we can see from the right, they've also got crossbows. Now the crossbow can only shoot twice per minute, but as we can see from the box over there, it will do more damage. You'll punch the close, male, boy. Now you beat someone to use a crossbow in an afternoon, but it is far more expensive to make. The English army has lots, the Scots are none. Now, part of the time thought the crossbow was so brutal that he tried to have it outlawed. It should not be used against Christian souls. So the English army decided to bring 300 of them. You can see the full reality here. As for Zeitz, these Genoese mercenary crossbowmen from Italy shoot into this spot of infantry coming out of the woods for them. Large you, ladies and gents, I'll be taking part with your boy and they're shooting off. Here they come. Where the crossbow is involved behind the least popular member of your family. Right, we've got back to the first day of battle, the afternoon of Sunday, the 23rd of June. It's 3:30 in the afternoon, and cometh the hour, cometh the man. To our left, in front of the tall woods, Robert Bruce is in front of his army, reviewing them, giving them speeches. At the front is a dangerous place for any commander to be. Either Bruce and the Scots still wobbling. Remember, they put down traps, anything to break up that English advance. So the Scots have been wobbling. From this direction, the English vanguard is going to approach, led by the 22-year-old tournament champion, Henry de Boer. He wants to make a name for himself. and he challenges Bruce to single combat. He draws in the battle and he goes out. He counts his lance and he charges. Let's see how he does. Not very well. Lord Paladin, Bruce gives the burn a funnel at the bottom. He splits his head in two. He can only complain and throw this thing out. First blood and stops. All right then, ladies and gents, that.
Getting a mark. She was down in superb condition.
It was
restored in 2013.
Oh, okay.
The owner just let it go.
It's not